So the pilot of a Southwest flight from New York to Dallas being called a hero tonight. Talking about Captain Tammy Jill Schultz, a Navy veteran able to land that crippled passenger jet in Philadelphia. See, an engine blew up mid-flight, thousands of feet in the air, spinning pieces of hot metal slicing into the jet and into a cabin window. One woman identified as Jennifer Roeden of New Mexico killed after partially being sucked out of that broken window at 30,000 feet. You can see the missing window. It's circled in this video here. Seven other people were hurt, but the entire incident could have been worse. Byron Day is in the newsroom now with that part of the story. Byron, I just can't imagine.
I know, Lanise, and pilots all over the country are trained thoroughly to handle any sort of emergency, and this terrifying incident, no exception. It's that training that allows the pilot to act quickly and instinctively to save his passengers and crew. I asked a veteran international pilot for Delta Airlines, Paul Carr, to describe for us what was happening in the cockpit the moment that engine exploded.
We get a warning. The first thing we're going to do is don our oxygen mask and establish communications between us. That is what we call emergency action items. We learn that by rote. We do that without thinking about it. And then we start an emergency descent. We have about four or five steps that we go through, once again, almost without thinking about it, to start an emergency dive down to 10,000 feet.
Carr also told me the reason the pilots have to get those oxygen masks on first is because if they don't, they only have seconds before becoming confused and disoriented due to a lack of oxygen at higher altitudes. Carr went on to praise his fellow pilot for dealing with not only the rapid explosive decompression inside the jet, but also the loss of an engine and still being able to get the plane on the ground safely. Tonight, NTSB investigators are trying to figure out why that engine exploded.